the concept of Ambedkar tourism. So panel member, I request you all to please have discussion topic which is related to how to market and how to develop this product of Ambedkar tourism, so that the inputs will be useful for us to have some constructive suggestions which can be implemented. I request you all to please commence your discussion. I request everyone to discuss after one by one.
Honorable delegates and my friends, Dr. Ragde sir have a wonderful collection of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. I already seen Dr. Ragde's slides. My request to Dr. Ragde sir, one more destination they can add in this field, just 28 kilometers away from the Nagpur. That place is very wonderful and very beautiful place, that is Chincholi. You know, I think that is very nice and very beautiful. Babasaheb Ambedkar's all memorable things are they already kept there. So Dr. Ragde sir, I request you, you can visit to the Chincholi, that I think 28 kilometers away from the Nagpur, and you can arrange the one tour also. Then you can visit Nagpur, then go to the Chincholi and come back. You can see the Bandardara like that, Chikaldara, and then you can come back to the Aurangabad. So my suggestion is that you can add that place. That person already developed that place. They already kept that Babasaheb Ambedkar, that typewriting, then their pen, then Babasaheb Ambedkar's coat. That is, you know, what can you say that blades, the vostara, razor, and then very my mind observation they can keep there. So you can visit that place and you can definitely add this, such things in your collection.
I think it's really wonderful that a new word has been coined, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, the great personality. In fact, he himself is a big adhyaya, I should say, a big novel for all of us, because all these things which have become now a big monument, wherever you go all over India, all over the world, all these things, whatever it has been touched, Parisparsha, you can say Midas touch. So all these have become the places of heritage. I would like to add one thing into it. In fact, Aurangabad is a place where Dr. Babasaheb lived here for a long time, and he had a dream, like as Honorable Vice Chancellor had mentioned about it, that Aurangabad is a place where Ajanta and Ellora are in the vicinity of it. And maybe because of that, it is motivated Dr. Babasaheb to start a good college and start a new education movement. And because of him only, actually, this department and myself, for whomsoever here, are taking education, is just because of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. And I think in the area of university, in fact, you can start a project called Heritage Education or something like that, which is closely related to Dr. Babasaheb and his activities. As well as there are certain things like Ambedkar thought or something, the academic contributions of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, particularly to Indian education, that also can be kept in this heritage place. In the campus itself, it can be developed, and a special fund also can be arranged.
First, I would like to thank you, Dr. Rajesh Ragde sir, and the department for giving the opportunity to speak a few words about the international conference planning and development of Ambedkar tourism. Really, as Dr. Rajesh Ragde mentioned about his presentation about the work and about the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, he is the only person in universe. His thoughts still is relevant to each and every age. So he is not only Indian leader, he is a universal leader.
Global.
And now today I'm presenting Ambedkar International Mission. This the mission is not related to with any political wing or any ideology. It's just payback to society on the basis of the principles of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. I came from Dubai, automatically I strike my mind about the business. When the the sir was presenting the about the something niche product, immediately we were thinking about the how we can convert into product. So what I would like to suggest here, as you mentioned that in India there is a different ideology. Some may not like Ambedkarism or his philosophy, and most of the tourists are only followers. So how we can identify the other segments? So what I was thinking, sir, Ambedkar International Mission is doing their contribution to the payback to the society. Another activity of them, they want to called the propaganda about the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, each and everything, like about his writing and speech and volume books. So what we are doing there, we are identifying 25 countries. Now this year we are celebrating 25th years of the foundation of AIM, Ambedkar International Mission. So we have representation in 25 countries. So in this 25 countries, what we are going to do, we will identify the universities over there. So top universities, like starting from the Columbia University, Boston University, all the universities, Singapore universities, where we will donate all the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar writing and speeches books. So automatically it will give them impression what the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was there and what how he is relevant to each and every age. Then again, you know, the tourism business is a seasonal business, right? Every time we are thinking about the how, which season tourists will come and which season tourists will not come. So if you think the activities, if you just concentrate about the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar's life, so I think the two seasons we can make it, like March, April, May. March, April, May, because there is a relevance. 8th March is a Women's Day. 1st May is a Labor Day. And 14th April is a Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar birth and anniversary. So this 14th April is bridging the 8th March and the 1st May. So that period also we can consider. Then again, October, November and December. So October again, Dhamma Chakra Pravartan Din is there. Then again, Samvidhan Din is there. And Mahaparinirvan Din. So these are the two phases we can divide it, and according to that we can segment and we can promote this product. That I was thinking.
My name is Kim. I want to say two points about Ambedkar tourism. The first point is storytelling. There are a lot of places related to Ambedkar tourism. The area he has visited, for example, Ajanta Ellora, where he was born, where he studied, like this. There are many places dispersed around the point. This is to put into service stories. The second point is how to use local link. Tourism resources alone are not enough to attract tourists. By linking resources that are different from that of Ambedkar, it is creating new charm. It could be a great view or culture. Two things are used to create the new synergy. I think so.
Good afternoon, everyone. So as we are discussing about the theme that is planning and development of Ambedkar tourism, so as I am the research scholar of this department, I got this opportunity to work on this the project that is related to the places associated with the life of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Actually, it's the followers of Dr. Ambedkar, that they wanted to do something on Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So as we are in the tourism field, so I got that opportunity because of the Honorable Director of the department. So officially I was not working on that project, but still as it is a matter of interest for me, so I have worked on some of the aspects of that project. So during my field work of a PhD research work, I went to the Vadodara, So actually there were one incident, a bad incident with Dr. Ambedkar when he was working with this Baroda Sanskar. Baroda, at that time, that Sayadaw Gaikwad, he had given him a scholarship, and after coming back, finishing the, his education, he has to work with that Baroda. So, when he, due to that, during that period, the caste system was there, and the Dr. Ambedkar belongs to the lowest caste or the untouchables. The people who were there, they were not able to digest that, and they mistreated with him. So when I went to this field work, sir told me that just go to and visit the places where Dr. Ambedkar has stayed. So actually I went to the Vadodara. I don't know anything about that place. So just I called my one friend, he is working with the Central University of Gujarat. And I talked to him, I'm in this Vadodara, and my sir had asked me to gather some information related to that place. So then my that friend, he called some native student from that place, and then he gave me the information. Then I went to that particular place. So there are two important places to the Vadodara. One is the Parsi Inn. As the Hindu community, they denied a room on rent to Dr. Ambedkar. So Dr. Ambedkar, he has to work there. So how somehow he managed to get a room in a Parsi in that time. So I visited that place, and again that bad incident is like that, when the Parsi owner, he come to know that he's untouchable. So again some people came with the lathis and he threatened him. Then again when working with this Baroda that time in office, so again in office also he had some bad experiences. So after getting all these bad experiences, Dr. Ambedkar come to one place and he sit down, and he literally cried, and due to the caste system, what problems he has faced. It means highly educated people at that time, at that just imagine this 100 or 20 years, 120 years back, a student from a very well known university, when he comes to the place, still not able to get the room or not able to give his services. So he sit that place and he decided to revolt against the system. So I went to that place. It is just a small chabutra vagare mhanto tasa kelele, and tithe tyanne te place maintain kelele. Tar asha prakarche pan kai chote chote places ahet ki je ya Ambedkar tourism cha project madhe apan include kele jau shakto. So I was talking again about the Chinsoli, as I am right now working with the University of Nagpur. So before coming to this conference, sir had asked me to collect the information about that place. So the Chinsoli, it is a place where the place called the Shantivan.
Shantivan, correct.
Yeah, the one person, he had collected all the belongings and the utensils of the bed, of the typewriter, of the clothes which was used by Dr. Ambedkar, and he has maintained that, and he again approached to the state government for this conservation and preservation. So it is a land of I think more than 11 acres. So they have created one museum and they have stored the all the these belongings of Dr. Ambedkar at that collection. So these are the lesser known destinations. In our tourism studies we say that the places which are not very much familiar to the tourists, so which can be these places are the potential tourist attractions. So tourists can come there if the proper marketing is done. So actually this Ambedkar tourism, it is a type of niche tourism. So for the niche tourism, we have to be very selective. Very few people, those are having interest in that particular area, they will visit that particular place. So when you want to promote a place which is a lesser known, so then you have to consider, you have to take the help of all the tourism stakeholders. It may be the government organizations, it may be the travel agencies, tour operators. So when all tourism stakeholders, they will get acquainted with this new type, I will say rather it is a new form of tourism, a personality based tourism or a Ambedkar tourism. Again, there are few examples are there, like in South Africa also. So where Gandhi, spent most of his life in Africa. He has conducted some satyagraha or some initial movement where he has started. So the government of South Africa, so they have started with this type of tourism, that is the places associated with the life of Gandhi. So likewise also we have to identify the places associated with the life of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, which are not very much well known. So the places which we have known or the places which are familiar due to the life of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, so where what we find that there is a mass tourism. So the followers of Dr. Ambedkar, they will visit these places on certain occasions. Like sir has also correctly mentioned on their slides, which are the dates. So on that particular days, the thousands and lakhs of tourists will visit. But how to increase the tourist flow to that particular destination throughout the year? That is what I think that is most important. And once that destination becomes popular, so definitely the other tourists or the leisure tourists, we say, they also start to come in such places.
First of all, I would like to thank the department for having me here for the panelists. I studied semester schooling in Espirul. Near college, there is a memorial which was shown in the slide. The American memorial was founded in 2015. As sir said, that all the belongings from Delhi. So they were given or donated to the symbiosis to Professor Majumdar sir. So when I went there, I saw there were not much people around there. So I asked the watchman that 14th April into 7th December, the auspicious of the occasions. So are there any events or functions that are being taken? He said no, there are not much. Some followers come and that's it. The main problem I thought was that place was not marketed well. It was in the heart of the city, still there was not much knowledge about it. Even our college students don't know that there is a memorial of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So I think that through proper marketing, as Babasaheb said, that there are many untapped areas, and we should recognize them and try to market them well.
Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar is deeply relational, so and Khorasan has a Buddhist university, and there is statue of Babasaheb. I took this photo in Japan, so but I asked the Khorasan people, but they don't know the statues and Dr. Babasaheb, so I would like to more know the more to Japanese people. Okay, thank you.
There are so many Japanese people in Khorasan. You say toward the Khorasan University in front of the ground, Babasaheb Ambedkar statue. But around Japanese people, they don't know who is dead. First issued many advertised about Babasaheb Ambedkar. Is there no first time trip to the to India and relative Babasaheb Ambedkar? There are some Japanese people, they don't know the Ambedkar. First there are new is first, I think.
Wow.
it is very necessary to the advertisement like that Nagarjuna already told about Dr. Babasaheb and Mr. Young Man, very energetic and young man, he also told about Babasaheb Ambedkar. Who is the Babasaheb Ambedkar? In other countries, actually they don't know. They have a statue of the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. But problem is that
who was the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar? And it is our duty to go to the proper channel, to the people, to in Japan, in Malaysia also, Colombo also. In Malaysia, I think Kuala Lumpur, there is one statue also Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, but the same thing is happen in there. So that person, they don't know about the Babasaheb Ambedkar. So it is the nice idea to Dr. Ragde, and I congratulate Dr. Ragde. They organize that is such a wonderful themes and wonderful international conference about Babasaheb Ambedkar. It is very energetic and very useful to the people. So my suggestion is that to everyone, you spread your ideas, you explain your thoughts about Babasaheb Ambedkar to everyone. That is our duty.
Thank you, Dr. Sir. In fact, many issues have been discussed. Particularly, the stress has been given on an untapped area where Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar had gone throughout the world. Wherever the places he had gone. But I would like to pay attention on a different aspect. I have here Mr. Dhere, who is actually a very good organizer. He has got his own travel agency, and I think we are only working on area that can be tapped, and so that the Ambedkar tourism can be increased. In fact, this place is where Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar had initiated the education movement. By taking the same note, I would like to say that a group of people from different parts of countries or different universities, the way these two gentlemen from Japan have come, or the our alumni, in fact, who had come from long way from Dubai, we can organize similar conferences where Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar had worked in different areas. There are so many areas where Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar had worked. His principal area was economics. He worked in social reforms. He was a freedom fighter. He was a great anthropologist. He was a great engineer, I should say. I remember one book Dr. Khushwan Singh had written. In that book, he had clearly mentioned the ministers, in one of the quotations it was mentioned, I think many British officers have worked from 1947 to 1955 so far. Till the first five-year plan was launched. Many British officers were there in India, and they have not left India from that time. In his book, Khushwan Singh had written that among all the ministers I have seen, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was the most efficient and most knowledgeable, meticulous and sincere minister. I think that is the great compliment to all of us. In spite of all the busy schedule, so many things he has in his mind, and he has only 24 hours to go for, as like us. But he has planned his life in a such way that, and I think we have to have some model here that actually attract tourism from different places. Like we can have number of conferences, a series of conferences in Aurangabad itself. Like if suppose from 1st to say 14 January, we can have conferences based on Namo Vistar Din or something like that. So every time we have to take one incidence, and based on that we can conduct conferences, say from Japan, say for Korea, say for Americans, say for English people, say for German, say for, you know, like for different countries. We have delegates in different countries. Even the Department of Tourism Administration can have an exchange program, can have MOU with them, so that we can actually conduct the conferences throughout the year, so that in that way I think the area can be tapped, and automatically this area will become famous from all point of view. like what we had dreamed or what Babasaheb had dreamed about this area, to make this area world famous in the field of education. And I think we have to concentrate on that part first. I mean, to be sitting at this place. So, like a series of conferences can be arranged by taking initiative of, you know, Teresa or, you know, many people of such kind. We can ask some good travel agency to have good marketing throughout the world. Thank you.
I agree with the point he has mentioned about the arranging the conference. Arranging the conference, it is, I think, it's important for the stakeholders. To extend that point, I would like to think about the, as he is mentioning about the, those students are not aware about the destination, it's the untapped area. So to attract the tourists, what we can do? I think we have to think on that point here. So like, for example, every year we have a different festivals. So as I earlier mentioned about the two seasons. So during that season, can we arrange some kind of festival so they can come? And again, as we are discussing, we are talking about all the goody-goody images. But we are in the Indian system. There are a lot of people are there. Different ideologies are there. We have to see the back side, the other side of the coin. Because, you know, Dadar, there are some incidents I have seen the news. When the people are coming from all over the India over there, the locals are going for the holiday for the other destination. They said it is difficult for us to leave to 3 days over there. So this is the mentality of people over here. So how we can convert this? So we require a good content. We require a brainstorm sessions. Again, the marketing channel, what marketing channel we are using, as this is a disruptive era. And the disruptive innovation, what were the marketing channels we are using? I would like to share an example when we are organizing some events in UAE, particularly celebrating the Dr. Vasankar Jayanti. So we are just writing some articles and the invitation in the English language. So we didn't get the much response. Then we thought if we convert it into different languages, like Arabic, like Punjabi, Malayali, and then we got the wonderful results. So whatever marketing channels we are using, we have to think about the language. Because these people are not aware about it, because there is no literature available. Whatever literature available, either it is in Marathi or in English. So if we convert into other languages, particularly our segment, that would be very useful to position this product. That's it. Local partners over there, they know very well. So we can have a meeting with them and we can ask them how we can promote. Because sitting over here, what is happening in Nagpur and what is happening in Pune, so we don't know. But the local stakeholders can understand what is the problem area, and we can work on that problem area.
So suggestion for academicians
and researchers. Just I have to answer your questions, or I can add else if I want.
Okay.
I think academicians and researchers, more research needed to be done on this topic. As this is, I think, just we have, or the sir has given the concept. Okay, the what we can say in the language of research, it is conceptual research. It has, or the pioneer research in this field has done. But I think there are many more areas which can be explored on this, or related to this field. Like when we are promoting any type of tourism, so we have to look at how we can give a complete product for that tourism product. Like if you are trying to market or promote this Ambedkar tourism, then I think the other aspects like a culture, the different culture is there. The followers of Dr. Ambedkar, they have their own culture. They have developed their own culture. Like they are having some inspirational songs, or their way of celebration of Dr. Ambedkar Jayanti or other activities. I think you have, again, we have to ask, focus on these aspects also, not only the places associated with his life, but also the cultural aspect of this Ambedkarite movement, we can say. And again, one thing I would like to tell you that many people misunderstood Ambedkarism, okay? Or it is a typical, our Indian mentality is that we have confined our the great personalities, be it Ambedkar, be it Gandhi, be it Shivaji Maharaj, or be it anyone. So we have confined all our these great leaders within our communities. So when we talk about Dr. Ambedkar, so only the Buddhist people, or be specific, only the Mar community is talking about that, or that is the only interest of theirs. When we talk about Shivaji Maharaj, so somebody is talking about Shivaji Maharaj, then simple mentality is that these people belong to Maratha community. So I think this, the caste barrier is also important aspect, and that has to be resolved through this academic and research also. So how to overcome these caste barriers? So when we talk about the Dr. Ambedkar, he is not only the constitutional framer, he is not only the hero of the downtrodden, but he is the nation builder. So we have to project Dr. Ambedkar as a, not only the leader of Pacific community, but as a leader of nation, or he is the leader of our nation, or he is the nation developer. So, and again, one thing I would like to add, that is, everybody knows Buddha. Buddha knows, or whole world knows Buddha. Okay. So when we want to project Dr. Ambedkar in the other countries, not specifically the Buddhist country, so I think we have to project Dr. Ambedkar as a revival of Buddhism in India. So we know that though once upon a time the Buddhism was at its peak in India, but after a gap of 700 or 900 years, Dr. Ambedkar has revived the Buddhism in its own country. So I think that is the most important point we can promote, or we can, as we say him as a Bodhisattva, or the person who is about to enlighten one. So I think that image we can project. So it is difficult to project the Ambedkar to the foreigners, but we can have this connecting link of Buddhism while promoting Dr. B.R. Ambedkar to the foreigners. Thank you. I should reply or somebody else?
Okay, thank you. In fact, government organizations should realize that there is a movement, Ambedkarite movement, and which is very popular in the whole world. That is one thing. Because sometimes what happens in government realizes it after, very late. So once you realize that there is a movement and there are certain heritage places which are associated with it, like the way they have started with the Panchatirtha tourist destinations or Samanta Express. So if such kind of initiatives are extended on a minute level, all over India as well as abroad also, it is not necessary that Panchatirtha or Samanta Express can be there only in India itself, but there are some places all over the world which are associated. So government can take up an initiative, raise special funds, set up good museums in such cases, or promote the research activity so that more and more heritage places can be explored and they can be developed. This is what actually a kind suggestion for the government agencies, so that, you know, the tourism can be, real tourism can be explored and can be grown. Thank you.
No problem. Sir already told about the Shivaji Maharaj and Babasaheb Ambedkar. Lastly, I would like to say something. Sir, Gita pe Hindu chalta hai, Bible pe Christian chalta hai, Quran pe मुस्लिम चलता है, लेकिन मेरे बाबा साहब के संविधान पे पूरा हिंदुस्तान चलता है. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
Thank you very much.